Okay. So, this is what I mean by okay. I like and I write. Okay. R tu apa? I lupa lah. Tapi R, I write ni pun sama je. I like kan? Cuma nama je beza. Okay. So, next. So, what is I like? I like I issue the problem, dispute, the question. So, when you are given a set of question, of course you have to find the issue. Normally, the issue will reveal who are the parties involved, and of course, sometimes tengoklah juga. Sometimes dia punya parties tak ada, and dia just cakap advise the party in the question lah, in the situation, or advise the defendant ke macam tu kan. And then for the problem, normally a dispute, it will be depending on the scenario itself lah. Sometimes people look at, looking at, different way tau. Macam I, kadang-kadang memang I contract, but because I learn further kan, macam ada tort, and then sometimes there is criminal and all. But then for your level, macam I will give you just the question with regards to partnership. I focus on partnership law and contract law. Okay, but of course the discussion will be bigger lah kalau you dah panjang kan, apa dah further. But then for your level, your exam kali ni just focus on contract and partnership. That's it. Okay, don't focus on anything else. Although you can see, because some of the frontliner kan, you can see, oh, there is a criminal breach something kan. Especially when it comes to criminal. Tak payah masukkan penal code. Okay? Just focus on partnership and of course contract. Contract as the main lah. Okay? Law of agency, I combine dah. Combine with the partnership. Partnership punya ni lah question. And then for contract, it will be a combination, a little bit of sale of goods and I purchase ada kot. I purchase I own. Because yang tu dia different kind of thing eh. Okay, then LR, law atau rule. Jurisdiction and case. Okay, after you determine what is the issue. So normally I would love you to start with this one. The issue is whether. Peter. Simple. Okay. Kalau let's say the question with regards to ni kan, with regards to contract, and the question is whether there is a contract. Dah. The issue is whether there is a contract between A and B. Something like that. Pretty simple. This one pun dah berapa markah? 2, 3 marks lah. Okay? Because determining the apa the issue is very important, because that one of course lah, it's your mod ni ya, you punya apa problem lah, problem statement, and of course you want to find a solution for that kind of issue. Okay, law, rules, jurisdiction and cases. Okay, cases you can put under application. Okay, application analysis tau. Tapi you have to mention better lah. You mention law. Selepas law. Okay, that means if you are talking about the basic foundation of a contract will be offer, acceptance and consideration. Okay, as according to section 2 subsection A of the Contract Act 1950, it stipulates that an offer is when someone will apa willingly okay to do or to abstain blah 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 blah. Itu dia. Okay, you can take like 100%, just copy and paste 100% from the act, no problem. But then put the ni lah apa yang kata bendedah penutup tu kan. And then if you are better, your understanding is much better, maybe you can sum up the act lah, the statute. I mean like the article or the section. But I don't recommend that. It's better for you to just stick to that section, letak je copy and paste. Lepas tu copy and paste ni lah. And then baru you discuss. If you want to further discuss about it, okay, this section highlights the requirements of such law, okay, such apa such elements to be fulfilled in order to get your contract enforced by law lah, macam something like that, okay, senang. And then rules, rules and law ke sama, okay, it can be article from Federal Constitution. Or if you are doing apa company law, you can read the article of association. And then if you're talking about the akta or statute, it's going to be section lah. But make sure This one, I have to emphasize that you have to put first, kalau you nak discuss about, okay, let's say general. You are talking about general, eh? The general rules of, let's say, elements of contract. Section 2, define, define, eh? Definition, definition. But then, if you are referring to section, offer sahaja, is going to be section 2, subsection A, right? Of contract. So, always make sure that you put the exact lim or the exact lim, eh? I mean A, B, C tu kita panggil lim, eh? So, specifically, dia akan jelah, jangan terlalu general. Okay, macam tu boleh kita letak according to Contract Act 1950. Because this is very important, because if you are referring to section 2, section 2 banyak. Because section 2 is definition punya section. And it give what's the definition of offer acceptance consideration. And what are these parties are going to be called? Offer or offeree ke promisor promisi? Macam tu, eh? And then, okay, kalau but you can mention lah generally section 2 defined every words in the contract. Okay, general words ke apa, okay? Then A stands for application or analysis. This is very important because analysis actually tests on how students understand the law and issue above. Law, issue and, oh, lupa nak cakap pasal case. Case pula tak ada masalah, judicial precedence. Okay, case macam contoh, you are talking about the Contract Act. What's the basic of, there are two types of offer, unilateral and bilateral. How you hide apa ni, prove that, okay, by using Khalil against Smokeball, inilah Smokeball lah. They one actually the pre they set the rules of unilateral and bilateral kind of contract. Okay, nanti yang tu I tak nak explain panjang, that's it. Or ITT, you are talking about invitation to trade. It is not an offer, but it is an ITT. The general president, the general president pula, president case will be, let's say example, you ambil pharmaceutical, cash book, okay? Itu pun boleh juga, something like that. You have to choose to pick the, orang kata the precedent case dulu, barulah the latest case. And I would say that most of the cases under contract law will be derived from UK, the UK, eh, because we use common law kan. So formulation case is quite ni lah, not familiar, familiar pula, not famous lah, macam orang tak guna sangat, okay. Application analysis ni, okay, what you need to do, you have to blend the issue, the law and the case. Okay, then based on that particular, you kena analyse. Nanti kita tengok macam mana, sekejap. Then conclusion. The conclusion, advice, suggestion to the parties involved. You don't need to settle the problem, eh. Contoh dia macam, in my opinion, A will be punished, ataupun A will be punished under section no need. Okay, so it is advisable, something like in my opinion, as according to section as according to the explanation, something it is it can be said that there is a contract lies between A and B, therefore A supposed should perform the contract as per according to the ni lah, what stated under the contract. Okay, something like that. Simple kan? Okay, next. Okay, this is the question. This one is famous. You got a question, something about consideration when it comes to loved ones. Okay, Jimmy proposed to give his brother, tak apa, kita pergi ke analysis dia. Okay, ni. So, Jimmy proposed to give his brother RM1,000 monthly, okay, on the condition that their mother transfers one acre of land to him. Their mother agreed on the said proposal and did the transaction later to him. Okay. Jimmy, however, failed to fulfill his agreement and his brother sued him for the breach of his contract. So this is the issue lah. Okay, tak apa, tak faham ke apa ke nanti, tak tepi. So, kita first kali you have to analyze the question. Who are the parties involved? So, in this case, you can see that there is the third party pula. Okay, Offeror is actually Jimmy, anak dia. And then Offeror give the proposal lah. And then the offeree, dia punya mak. Because there is transaction of goods, okay, land, sorry, land. So that's why it is considered as a consideration. Because the subject matter, what is the subject matter? 1 acre of land. Okay, their mother agreed on the blah, blah. Lepas tu, acceptance has been stipulated whenever their mother agreed. Because she is the offeree lah. And then, Jimmy, however, failed to fulfill his agreement. However, the promise made to his mother is actually for his brother. That means the third party. And then, that the third party is blood, ada blood connection dengan the offeror. Okay, so his brother sued him for breach of his contract lah. So advise Jimmy. Okay, some part of this situation, we think that, family members. So there is an affection of love. So it is the responsibility. It's not a contract. It's the responsibility, not the liability. Okay, but then what courts, yeah? Okay, no, remember if you look at the situation, the parties involved in the case will be Jimmy, the defendant, and his brother, the plaintiff. Because the one that seek for judgment, since for fairness, is actually the fairness of the his brother. Mak dia mungkin dah mati masa tu. Okay? Ni soalan je lah. Since the question requires you to advise Jimmy, sebab directly dia kata the question dah cakap advise Jimmy. That means you have to advise Jimmy lah. But at the same time, you can give a suggestion for the two party, the other parties, which are the brothers. Okay? Tak ada masalah. Okay, because any advice is workable for Jimmy or for brothers. And then, tengok cara saya jawab. The issue is whether Jimmy's brothers have the right to sue him for breach of contract. Okay, or lagi satu, whether the issue is whether there is a contract between Jimmy and his brother. But, okay, yang ini, issue dia, you boleh focus on, okay, dia ada dua sekarang ni. Faham tak? Perasan tak? The issue is whether Jimmy's brother have the right to sue. This is when we talk about the who are the offeree. Okay, the offeree was his mother, not the brothers. So, boleh tak dia berpindah milik? Maknanya, the offeree or the acceptance tadi tu, can the acceptance goes from, transfer from one person to another. If it is related blood related relationship, ada blood relationship, or what are the laws or legislation stipulated or implemented that govern this condition? Okay, whereby we need to see the consideration dia actually macam business ni, because ada tanah, betul tak? But the problem is dia dah transfer ke ada orang, maknanya transaction tu dah tak ada, the second party dah tak ada dah. So the third party. But the obligation to be made is for the third party. So that's why kita kena tengok betul-betul dia punya issue. And then, okay, law. To establish the legal responsibilities between the parties, you need to determine the valid legal relationship of the parties involved. The reference should be as according to the local jurisdiction. In this case, Malaysia lah. Therefore, you should, okay, you can do Malaysia. Biasanya Malaysia tak banyak case. And the UK, India. Ni biasa orang akan guna tiga ni lah. Okay, therefore you should refer to Contract Act 1950 lah. Okay, so what this question focus on adalah these three. Nampak tak? Okay, dia besar tak? Dia punya ni. Saya takut dia punya phone dia kecil. Can see it clearly? Tadi yang nampak tu Nabi Luqman cakap tu pukul 9:16. So siapa? Kalau guna phone memang susah sikit lah sebab dia kecil. Okay, thank you so much, Masya. Okay, so let's say in this situation, of course, I will basically define dulu. And I always remind my students to read between the line one thing, and then if possible, please define every single words. Okay, tak adalah you nak define what is two apa. Okay, no. But we try to define yang tadi tu. The issue is whether there is a contract. Okay, there is a contract. Let's say I ambil ini. So, contract. If you want to define contract, you have to explain or you have to first define what are offer, acceptance and consideration. These three first. Tapi janganlah panjang lebar. Okay, offer, section berapa, these are the basic lah, tiga. And then, acceptance, section berapa, section 2, subsection B. If I'm not mistaken. And then, 2, subsection D will be the consideration. Sekejap, aku ni pun mana tak letak. Tak apalah. Check kalau salah, beritahu . Okay, and then, lepas tu, I focus on section 2. Nampak, I generalkan dia. Okay, the general term section 2 of the Contract Act 1950. Okay. I rasa kelas kita akan fokus pasal ni je. I think this is much better kot because you nak jawab nanti senang. Sebab case study akan kau soalan macam ni. Boleh tak? Yang okay, I ada video sale of goods. Lepas tu I purchase, I ada record half. I boleh share dengan you. Okay? Tadi pagi record. Boleh tak? Any objection? Lain tak cemerlang. Bila nak cemerlang tu bang? Sekejap, nak I besarkan lagi dia. Alahai, mengada lah benda ni. Apa? Semak lah law belakang tu kan? Kita delete lah. Okay. Kalau tak dapat, alamak, saya pun lupa nak share lah. Saya share dekat guru jap. Kesian ni orang yang tak dapat tengok kan. Asalnya dah share dah sebelum ni. Cuma tak sempat discuss lagi. Cuma jumpa sikit sekala. Okay, this one. Mana tadi? Okay, I share dekat ni. Okay. Dah share dekat group . Okay, then. Okay. Section 2 of the Contract Act. I cakap ni, this one is general. Very general lah actually. But, you see the below there, I put what is specific. Okay, satu tinggal. Section. Section berapa tadi? Section 2, subsection B. Okay, of CA . And subsection C tak payah sebut lah sebab that one is only for the terminology. Okay, what is what we call offer and offeree . Offer lah, acceptor apa? Offeree lah 1950. Okay, this is for your acceptance. Okay, lagi okay, so the issue sekarang is whether there is a contract. Betul tak? Because if you read through consideration, we are talking about the relationship punya ni kan, of love and affection. Okay? Sekejap . Ada soalan sebelum tu? Tanya je. Sebab tak pun dah tergabung. Hari ni siapa tak tanya pula? Macam lengang. Ni sistem. Oh ni this one. Okay. So yang ni pun tak lengkap tau actually. I mean like the explanation under this notes. Dah Ita. Dah bagi dekat dalam tu dah. Groups. Dah share dah dekat groups. Dekat ni. Ni salah ke? Dah share tu. Okay. So this thing. Banyak tau actually. Kalau I yang bila I explain, I akan explain more into, of course, where there is a contract. Ada kan? Sebab apa? There is an acceptance. Okay. But the issue will be, whom can an offer be made? Macam, you can create the issue tau, actually. Okay. Issue lain yang you boleh sebut? I biasa akan conteng slide macam ni. Memang akan conteng. So you baru boleh nampak live. What is that? Okay, whom can an offer be made to? Does the law say that you cannot give any offer to your family members? No, right? So, kalau tak ada, then benda ni don't discuss. Okay? You have to focus on something else. So, sekarang yang you nampak is actually whether the brothers have the right to sue, kan? Betul tak? First of all, you can actually dig into the relationship between Jimmy's and brothers. Memanglah the relationship kan, blood relationship. Whether the contract between Jimmy and her mother can be transferred. There's another one. Dia punya blood kecil ni lah. Apa point kecil dia? I explain as whether an acceptance of the performance, sorry, the performance or consideration. Consideration tak boleh lah. Okay, performance lah of the said contract, the contract can be whether the performance of the contract can be done by the third party. Betul tak English aku ni? Macam pelik je. Betul lah. Okay, the third party. But sekarang ni dia ada relationship kat situ kan, the third party. Ini pun dia punya a bit of explanation. Okay, so what I discovered, section 10 first. What agreement is a valid contract? Let's see, section 10, it talks about what is actually a contract. Kalau boleh buka, buka eh. Sebab saya tengah mencari ni. Mana aku punya company? Company pula. Kejap eh. Tak pernah buka Sinadurai lah. Sorry. Sinadurai. Buku tebal sikit. Sebab this is the book for ultimate sources lah. Ada dua version. Dua volume. The first and second. I think one is 400 something. You pun request my sister lah. Okay. Third party is Jimmy's brother. Yes. Betul, Monisha. That's why. The issue is quite complicated tau.